Okrama Media in Johannesburg, I'm Sane Dlamini. Joining me today is uMngeni Mayor Municipality Chris Pappas to discuss his position. Can you tell us what this position means to you?
Thank you. Thank you very much, and thanks for having me. Well, at the start of the campaign, we set out with a goal, and our goal was to change people's lives. This was a local government election, and local government election is about bread and butter issues. And the people or the team that we've assembled are all local people, you know, all come from different communities within this area. And we said we have a goal of changing people's lives. We were tired of seeing the decay. We were tired of seeing people that we grew up with, you know, with different opportunities in their lives compared to ours. And we wanted to change that. So that's the biggest thing that we've taken from this, is that we now hold power to actually affect change in people's lives.
And you are very close to the community, Chris, and I'm sure you know exactly what the pressing issues that needs to be addressed in your municipality. Would you please unpack that for us?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think it's important that elected leaders are in touch with what the communities need or our communities need. We shouldn't take positions of power as reasons to be distant from our communities. You know, positions of power should mean that we are closer to the people so that we can actually understand the daily struggles of even people outside of our direct communities. But, you know, there's five key priorities that we have said that we want to focus on. And those are, the first is job creation and a growing economy. That's obviously important because jobs bring dignity and able people can put bread on the table. The next is waste and the environment. We only have one planet, so we want to look after that to make sure that we look after the environment. But our communities are also filthy, so we want to get those clean. Next one is a transparent and responsive government. We need to make sure that our government is there for the people at all times, and to make sure that, you know, we are providing information and relevant information to our communities to advance themselves. The next one that we said was safer communities. We all live in South Africa, and we realize how unsafe many places are. So to find ways to make our communities safer. And then the last one was infrastructure investment and maintenance. And that includes roads, water, streetlights, electricity, eventually when we can, housing. But, you know, the basic infrastructure that we need to make our economy function and for people to have good lives that they live in their different communities.
Yeah, Chris, you recently appointed your deputy mayor, Sandile Mnikati, who's also 26 years old, who also grew up in Mpopomeni. Why do you think that he is your right-hand man?
So Sandile is highly qualified. He's very intelligent. He grew up in the area, so he understands people's needs.
Yes.
He grew up in an environment that's completely different to mine. So, you know, I grew up in a privileged environment where Sandile grew up in much harsher conditions. So we balance each other. We have different life experiences. We also work well together, and we have a similar vision for the people of uMngeni. We are able to disagree with each other without, you know, fighting with each other, which is good. We must always have debate and we must engage with each other. And he's also got a lot of potential for the future. So I've got to think about one day when I step down and who's going to take over from me. And Sandile is a really great guy with a lot of potential.
And he has promised to work hard in addressing youth unemployment through the businesses that you have partnered with. Can you tell us about those partnerships?
We've come from a time where private sector has largely been the enemy of government, or government finds them the enemy. We need to find ways to partner with the private sector. The municipality can't employ everyone, and we need to be honest with people. You know, the real jobs are going to come through small businesses starting up, or big businesses expanding, new businesses investing here. And we need to make that easy for them. We need to say, where are the challenges? How can we make your lives easier? Because the easier it is for business, the more jobs are created and the more people are employed. But also importantly is that we don't want young people just to be employees. We want young people to be employers. So how do we support their ideas and their visions for whatever it might be in a way that is sustainable?
And what would you say, Chris, to those who don't trust that your party, the PA, is going to turn things around in uMngeni municipality?
It's the same thing I've said to everyone, is that, you know, we can't judge a political party without giving them an opportunity. If after 5 years, you know, you feel that things haven't got better, absolutely criticize me and say, Chris, you failed, you're useless, whatever it might be, but give us a chance. Give us a chance to prove ourselves. Partner with us. You know, government is only as strong as the civil society that is behind it. So we're here to say, trust that this government is going to deliver, but become partners of that delivery, because at the end of the day, we don't want government to be far away from people. We want people to be the government. It's not Chris's vision, it's the community's vision. And we have to implement that as best as we can.
Can you talk to those now who may think that you have a magic wand to turn things around? Because clearly it's not going to be easy for you, Chris.
Government is slow and the processes are slow. We have very little money. A lot of the money has been stolen and the problems are greater than the resources that we have. But that shouldn't be an excuse. We have to make progress. And that's the important thing, is that if there were 100 streetlights that weren't working this week, there needs to be fewer next week. If there's 100 potholes this week, there needs to be fewer next week. But what is important is that people also need to realize what the mandate is of local government. So I've had lots of people, you know, approach me about issues with schools and issues with district roads and things like that. So we also need to be clear in the way that we communicate with people to say that this is what we can do. You know, in government, you do things because the law says you can. In business, you do things until the law says you can't, which is completely different. So we need people to understand what we can do and where we can't do something, how we can try to find partnerships with either other levels of government or the private sector to get it done.
We've had reports, Chris, that in your municipalities, some of the officials have started resigning because they are fears that they might be fired because of maybe being hired, because they qualified for those positions. Is there a thing like that in your municipality?
No, so that's just rumors and people being mischievous on social media. We checked with HR and with the municipal manager. No one has resigned, but that shouldn't be a warning to others. You know, we're not going on a witch hunt to check which political party you are with or any of those sort of things. If you come to work and you are willing to work and you want to get the job done, I don't really care what political party you are from or who you vote for. When you enter the municipal gates, you are a municipal worker there to serve everyone. The other thing that people need to watch out for, and this is, the warning, is that there have been people who have benefited illegally from contracts and tenders and appointments because they are brothers of this person and sisters of this person and they're not qualified for the job. Those are the people that need to be worried.
And lastly, do you have a plan to address work ethics within the employees in the municipality to make sure that you create a corrupt-free environment while fulfilling the needs of the people?
Corrupt-free environment is one. And, you know, there's no political party in the world who doesn't have some sort of corruption. I mean, we'd be lying if we said that. The important thing is what happens when you find that corruption. When you find it and when it exposes itself, that is the difference between a good political party and a bad political party. And when we find the corruption, we're going to take harsh action. But in terms of the work ethic, yes, we must make sure that we are working with unions, we're working with senior managers to make sure that firstly, people enjoy coming to work. We don't want people to come to work and feel as if, you know, that it's the most terrible place to work and you can't get things done. I took a walk around some of the offices yesterday and there's cramped conditions and people are in tiny offices and there's no storage space. You know, you can't expect someone to enjoy doing their work if it's a terrible place to work. So that's the first thing. But also to make sure that, you know, we have labor practices, we have key performance indicators and the rest of it. If we're not performing well, then we need to make sure that there's consequences. And slowly, the ethos or the culture of democratic alliance governance will filter through the municipality.
There was uMngeni Mayor Chris Pappas speaking to Crema Media's Polity about his position and the service delivery in uMngeni Municipality.